Bonjour Madame Monsieur and welcome to my channel. In this particular video, I have a challenge. This editing could have been a lot easier, but right bottom corner, I've got something peeking through. So if that wasn't there, this photograph would have been phenomenal. In this particular video, I'm going to do two things. One, my creative and technical process in Silkypix Developer Studio Pro as usual. And then I'm going to bring it over to Affinity Photo and try my best to get rid of that. I think it should be a lot easier because I'm going to crop quite a bit and then I will have few less thing to worry about. Let's see how things go. And before I jump into the editing, please like and subscribe and share if you like my videos. That will help me a lot to progress and create more contents like that. So without any further ado, let's jump right in. First of all, technical aspect of this photo. This photo is taken in f22 at 1/60th of a second, ISO 320 with the Fuji film. This is a Fuji file and I'm editing in Silkypix Developer Studio Pro. Anyway, that being said, if you're using any other software, Lightroom for instance or Capture One, the editing process will go pretty much the same. So don't worry, I will use all the basic tools available in any software. Now, normally, those who have been following my video knows that I always start with the lens correction. But again, it's a Fuji file, so I don't need to worry about it too much. Chromatic aberration, I'm going to turn it on for two reasons. Normally, I trust Fuji, especially their lens are phenomenal. That being said, more f-stop, meaning that it will create more diffraction and all kind of weird lens stuff. So I'm going to simplify those terms as well for the folks who don't understand them. Generally, more f-stop means that there's a good chance you might see like chromatic aberrations and all kind of problem with the lenses. So that's the reason why I'm going to turn on a chromatic aberration. Now I've done that, so I'm going to close this panel so that I have more workspace to work with. Now there's a few things I need to make a decision. One, white balance. Now, at the time of the taking photograph, I already had white balance in my mind and that's exactly what I kept. But because I like this sunshine, I like it to be a bit more warm. So I'm gonna go close to 5800. Hint, same. I'm going to make it a bit more red. So my objective is to make it nice and orange then again. But in the shadow, as you can clearly see, shadow, I have a different idea. Shadow, I want a little bit more into the green side. In the dark adjustment, I'm going to go toward minus 50, about minus 5. So my white balance are done too. While I'm editing, I'd like to explain a few things. What I want you to see. In this photograph, I want you to see three things. One, this little house. This gives a really nice impact and feeling for the whole photograph. It shows you the size of this little cliff. And the background will give you the sense of height. So I want both of them. So I have three most important elements. Of course, the sunshine will give you the what time of the day it is. So, and the distracting part here are two. One, this corner right there and the top. So I'm going to crop it. This is going to be easy one. So that I don't worry about. What I worry about is this one. So I'm going to start with the color. I'm going to film simulation. Again guys, if you don't have any film simulation, if you're not using any Fuji film, or if you're using something else, that's fine. Color is completely your choice. You are in charge. You make your creative decision. So my creative purpose, I want this photograph to be a bit more soft. So I'm going to go to Astia. I could go for Classic Chrome, my another favorite, or Pro Neck High. But Pro Neck High, I used to use it for video. Now I don't have Fuji anymore. So I'm going to go back to Astia. This is going to be interesting from now on, because I'm going to bring back details. So I've done my color, all the steps that necessary, the technical aspect of it. Now this is where the cropping comes. So I'm gonna crop the top straight away without any wasting time. So that part is gone. Now I think this photo will go really nice with the square. So I'm going to crop it. So this is my one part that I would like to keep. And from the right, let's see how far I can crop. I want this peak at the very, very center and the house. So you have the house and this peak. So I'm gonna crop a little bit more and I will go from the bottom. Just try to make my life as easy as possible. I hope, because if I crop there, I'm losing the house. And if I crop right there and bring this one over, it doesn't work at all. So me and you, we're going to solve the problem. So there I go. I'm going to go back right there and then finish my crop. So that's done. This is another part that I have to worry about. This corner, there's a little bit of shadow right there. That's fine. We can fix it easily. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the highlight here is way too strong. So I'm going to turn down the highlight. So what I do, you can use the highlight slider, obviously, because I'm using Silkypix Developer Studio Pro. I'm going to use Color Burn. Color Burn, let's see the result. And I'm going to zoom in quite a bit so that, you know, I'm assuming that you're watching in a smaller screen, not in the laptop. If so, highly recommended. If not, I'm going to zoom it for you. That's fine. So the white part is gone, which is beautiful, but I want to bring some contrast in this area. You have a little bit of shadow, which will give a bit more character. So in order to do so, I'll do all of them in Affinity Photo. Just like you would have done again in Photoshop, if you had Lightroom and Photoshop combo. Now I'm going to go to Noise Reduction and Sharpening. In order to do that, I'm going to turn my this part on and bring all the default setting back. So in default, SilkyPix Developer already applied its own Noise Reduction and Sharpening, which I trust this software. So I'm not going to play with it too much because we need a lot of time for the creative part. And then finally, just before handing it over to Affinity Photo, I'm going to bring my demosaic sharpening back. Those who doesn't know what is demosaic sharpening, this is the input sharpening that SilkyPix Developer allows you to put in, which is beautiful. I love it. So we are done. So final step will be open with another application. This is how I transfer the photo to Affinity Photo. And those, if any Capture One viewer here, you would do the same thing as I'm doing in Affinity Photo in Capture One, because I believe Capture One has almost similar kind of layer workflow, which is beautiful. I'd love to have this software one day. Now, ladies and gentlemen, where are we? So I'm going to make a duplicate. That's how I always do. Actually, a couple of duplicates. Now I'm going to turn this one on. This background, I'm going to lock it so it doesn't move anywhere. Now my first and very first priority would be getting rid of unnecessary spots. So in order to do that, I'm going to turn on my crop. Actually, that part on the top can go. Maybe I could crop on the side a bit more. I'm really hoping that I can be successful. Otherwise, this beautiful photo will be a waste. Honestly speaking, I would be very disappointed. Now enter. So I've got a few techniques here. So technique number one would be using that freehand selection tool. Now select the corner. Now once you select the corner, what you can do, go to edit, click in paint, and let's see the result. And I'm really hope that one click selection should do the job. And surprisingly, it did a freaking awesome job. I cannot be happy about it, more happy about it. So the option number two would be this part. And this is my challenge, my friend. I don't know exactly what's the result outcome going to be. I'm really hoping that for the sake of myself, my sanity, it gives a really good job. Actually, I'm going to get rid of it. So let's see. I have to be very precise. It doesn't really need to be precise because generally the Affinity Photo does a very good job. This is going to be complicated. Let's see. Yes. Right. So we are back on track, ladies and gentlemen. So I think I've done fairly good job getting rid of those two. Now I think I can crop it a little bit more as I wanted. So I'm gonna go back to my crop like that, a little bit more. I'm trying to make it not really square per se, but as square as possible. So enter. Now what did I say? I said we have three really important subject here. Subject number one is the house, second is the pig, third is the background. Now I want you to see the house properly. So what can I do? I can bring an adjustment layer, turn my brightness and contrast. Now I'm going to pull down the brightness quite a bit, but don't worry, you're saying that the photo doesn't have any depth anymore. That's fine. Now I'm going to brush on a couple of things. I'm going to basically change the blend mode to luminosity. Then I'm gonna go to the blend option, pull it down. So basically I'm trying to protect all the dark area and trying to work on our mid-tone and highlight. So that's that. We are done here. So I can close it. I'm going to bring my brush. Make sure it's selected black. Now brush on it. Make sure the brush is bigger enough and brush on the house. I don't care about the flow because I think that it's not really strong anyway. So I'm going to bring back my flow and my opacity and brush away. So there, that's gonna be my first step. So I'm hoping that you can see my house. And the second would be make the brush really small and adjust in this edge right there. So I'm gonna turn it there like that. So you cannot see it, you should feel it. Remember, if you can see my edit, I have a problem. So you have to make sure that you're not overdoing anything. Now, second option would be this house right there. So in order to do that, I can turn on my curve there, Control I, pull the brightness up quite a bit and pull the shadow right there, highlight there. Now make sure the brush selected white this time and brush it there. Not too much, just a little bit. That's fine. I could boost the saturation a little bit. Again, not too much, never too much, just a little bit. because nothing better than a really nice vibrant photograph, right? So I can bump it quite a bit, and there's a couple of things. Now I'm going to work on my contrast. So I've got a couple of technique in the sleeve. First of all, the clarity, but don't worry, I have a different technique for the clarity. For clarity, usually what I do, I always do local. First of all, I change my blend mode to luminosity. Now second, I always invert it. Third, pull it up as much as you can, that's fine. Now close it, make sure your brush is white, make sure your brush is big enough. Now brush on the edges and the house and brush away, because these eyes, I really love it particularly. So that's the part that I want to be crunchy and sharp, and I will protect my shadow area. There's another thing that I can do to bring up those dark spots on the wall is level. So what you can do to the adjustment level, then turn on level, always invert it, bring your black slider down quite a bit, change your blend mode to luminosity and close it. Don't worry about the flow. You can clearly see that there is something going on. So I can brush on this area. Now, here's another thing that I can do. I can go back to the blend range, change it. So I'm gonna go back up, bring back down. Let's see what happens. So I'm gonna go there and then keep brushing. See, all the dark spots are standing out quite a bit, and I like it. Now finally, my final contrast would be high pass filter. So in the high pass filter, all I do, just like everybody else, this is pretty straightforward. Always change the blend mode to overlay. Make sure the highlight is separated, high pass is separated, and zoom in about 100%. Make sure I'm not overdoing anything. Now I see all the way up, see what's the change. So I can see that it's way too much. I can see the hollows. So you bring it back about 5%. You never overdo it. You do it just about so they can feel it. This is a really nice and quick, not really quick, I understand that it was a little bit longer than usual because of the too many steps. There is no complication, it's just way too many steps to deal with the photograph. But other than that, our photograph looks really beautiful, nice and crunchy. And let me show you the photograph in 3, 2, 1.